find ourselves with?
Jake Longstreth.
Okay, Jake Longstreth. And I see you have an exhibition here at the Crisp-Ellert Art Gallery. It's part of the whole Flagler complex. And I was looking at your work, and we talked off camera, and I found it very soothing. What can you tell me about your art? What inspires you to do this kind of work?
It's landscape work, pictures of buildings, parking lots, the natural landscape. It's all informed by pretty casual daily existence. So this is a series of paintings of Blockbuster Video I did about 12 years ago when I realized Blockbuster Video was going to go out of business because of the internet. I thought that'd be kind of funny to do 9 paintings of different locations of Blockbuster Video with this sort of, just these different archetypes of like strip mall architecture, and just do like a bunch of really sunny, colorful paintings of this business that is going down the tubes in a hurry. And sure enough, they declared bankruptcy in 2010.
Yeah, I also saw you have some art where you see like a parking lot, and then you see this beautiful landscape.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, it's again like a completely common experience. That hand over there, it's called Campus. So it could be like the last faculty parking lot at like a college campus, or it could be like a corporate campus on a Sunday, or maybe after some layoffs or something. And there's just this, big empty parking lot. And
now you're based in California.
Yep, LA.
All right, Los Angeles. And what kind of feedback do you get from people?
All kinds.
Is there anything that you keep hearing repeated all the time?
Yeah, definitely that the paintings are very calm. There's a lot of space, like you said, soothing.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Which I don't mind hearing, because a lot of the paintings are of sort of harsh, even troubling places. So, if you can make a painting of like the most mundane architecture or like a parking lot, you can make the painting kind of have like a soothing.
Yes, because that's what I find interesting. Is a lot of this architecture is what we call a cookie cutter.
Yeah.
It's the same mall, same kind of thing, and yet through the colors and where you position everything, there's that calmness that comes out of it, which is to me is the the very interesting thing I wasn't expecting when I saw your painting. As soon as I walked into that room, that's what you felt, was that zen-ish kind of feeling.
So there's a conflict between the subject matter and the way the paintings are done.
Now, how do you pick your subject matter? Do you think of a subject matter, or do you suddenly drive into a place or go by a place? And
it's usually like accidental discoveries, driving by, like pull into a parking lot and there's like a bunch of trees or something, and you're just like, it's like something catches your eye.
Right.
And so,
okay. So how long is your exhibition going to be here?
I think till February 25th.
All right.
So a month and a half or so.
All right. And this is your first time in St. Augustine?
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you think about our town?
That's beautiful.
It wasn't what you expected?
Sort of. I mean, I read about it. I knew that it was like the oldest city in the
USA. Correct.
And so there's a lot of like funky old museums. The Spanish Military Hospital Museum.
Yes.
What is that?
Right.
So it's like, it's beautiful though.
Great. Well, I thank you for giving us this time.
Of course.
And I know you're going to have a speech engagement and like a PowerPoint presentation.
Yep.
Some of your work and what pushes you to do this, but we thank you very much.